Shangri-La dialogue will debate a lot of security issues, how to meet Asia's complex security challenges, how to manage military competition in this part of the world, and how to coordinate defense policies between different nations. How can these talks change the security situation and the cooperation dynamics among nations?
One of the characteristics of a Shangri-La dialogue is to focus on the hottest issue. So you actually would hear such words like challenges, uncertainties, all these kind of words. But what really would reflect regional security? Is the world becoming more dangerous, particularly in the Asia Pacific? Well, some people would argue like that, particularly because of tension in the South China Sea. But if we look at the rest of the world, the Middle East is definitely chaotic because of Syrian issue. And Europe is troubled with influx of endless refugees, with the possible exit of Britain from a European Union zone, or the almost hopeless debt issue of Greece. So comparatively speaking, Asia Pacific is booming economically. But in terms of security, yes, there are issues like DKB Arctic nuclear issue and tension in South China Sea. But by and large, people still believe this area is manageable and nobody is talking about a war.
About the South China Sea issue, they say it's an egg and chicken problem, because who is having the initial blame? Some say that China has been building up its military facilities, has been doing land reclamation on those islands. That's what triggered the U.S. military maneuver, including freedom and navigation operations in the South China Sea, by asking from the claimant, other claimants. What do you think?
Well, I think you're talking about militarization. Indeed, it's a bit like a chicken and egg question. But the point is, as the United States has claimed, it is taking no sides, and it doesn't have a position on the sovereignty of the maritime features in South China Sea. Therefore, logically, it comes to the DOC, which stipulates that this issue should be resolved between China and the claimants. In the wording, that is, countries that are directly concerned to resolve this issue, a sort of friendly negotiation and a consultation. So what is the role of the United States in this? The point is the presence, the frequent military presence, the patrolling of the United States in the South China Sea has actually made the situation more complicated for an issue which it has vowed not to be involved in.